So what's going on here today?
All right, so today we have a fall officials camp. We were mandated by the LHSAA to attend a camp once every 2 years as part of keep our certification as officials. So today is one of two camps that the state has held in the fall. We have close to 200 officials from all across the state, and it's a learning experience. The goal is learn something new today. We have 12 clinicians from major college conferences that are all graduates of GNOFOA, Greater New Orleans Football Officials Association. So it's good that these guys can give back and teach the younger officials, to take their game to the next level.
So I know there is somewhat of a shortage right now. How would you describe that?
There's a nationwide shortage. We're getting older. And the age of officials is going up, and we're not getting a younger crowd in to fill those needs and fill those demands. So we'll get 40 officials sign up year one. By the time we get to year three, we probably have 5 or 6 left. And they're leaving for various reasons. It's, time consuming. We meet every Monday night, and Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, you're officiating JV, varsity games. And it's a time commitment. We all have other jobs to do besides this. The lower levels, it's dealing with, and you've seen it at the Little Leagues, it's dealing with some of these parents. They just need to understand these guys are learning too, and we're all here to learn and do a better job. Nationwide, it's a problem. Last year we had to move some game times, pushing back so I can get a crew from a 3:30 game to a 7 o'clock game in time. And around the state, coordinators of officials, they're asking schools to go play on Thursdays and go play on Saturdays. And I've asked out of all the schools we serve in the New Orleans area and some schools on the North Shore, and they have, a few of them have moved games, which helps us out a lot on coverage on Friday nights.
The strain of that, having to move games, same crews doing multiple games in short spans of days, what are some of the consequences of, that happening?
Consequences, injuries. Right now, we know with the heat, you get playing games in August, early September, it's hot out there. And it's burnout, because you expect to do 2 games in a day, or asked to do 2 games in a day, and it takes a toll on you.
How much is that maybe factoring into the amount of people that are leaving?
Really none. The ones that have left, we kind of did a follow-up with some of them, and it's the time commitment. It's, dealing with some coaches and parents. I'm not out here at a fifth grade game to take the abuse I get.
Now, how long have you been involved, with officiating here in the state?
Yeah, so I was an on-field official for 30 years. Started doing the coordinator of officials position 2 years ago. And it's my 3rd year doing this. So I'm strictly off the field, just doing the coordinator of officials duties, which includes, evaluations, attending games, assigning all officials to games in schools we serve.
And what keeps you coming back? What's been the most rewarding experience of doing all this?
Watching young guys develop. We can get some guys that are 4th, 5th year officials and move them up and take them to the next level of, potentially getting into doing playoff games and doing state championship games. The last 2 years we've been very fortunate. We've had some guys with 5 or 6 years experience that are really good, and they've been rewarded because of their on-field performance with a state championship game. And, the downfall of getting and training really good young officials is we're losing him to the college ranks quickly. And that's the downfall of success. Yeah.
But to see that there is, a nationwide shortage, haven't been in this as long as you have, is that sort of a discouraging thing to see for a profession that you hold in such high regard?
No, it's not. It's good that we can develop these guys and move on to the next level. All the clinicians we had here are all graduates of GNOFOA, which is a good thing. They can come back, give their time back. But yeah, as someone who's developing, even what I call a workforce, the officials, to see them move on to bigger and better things, it's very rewarding.
So for someone on the fence that might want to get involved, what would you encourage them to do?
Contact us. You can go to the LHSAA website and get to LHSOA and sign up to be an official. We'll get notified and we'll invite you to our meetings and let you know what's going on and how to get involved. It's as we told, we have a really large class this year. We have 50 people who have been interested in officiating their 1st year. and probably 30 have showed up at the meetings, and we're going to, you know, try and get the rest of them to show up, or just, hey, come visit. And what we've told them, it's, you know, it's, they're going to be involved in the game. You know, if you're someone, ex-athletes, we have two of them like that, just finished playing college football, and they want to stay involved in the game. We got dads who their sons have graduated from high school, and they're back involved in the game. They want to stay a part of it. So it's that part of it that, you know, it's gives us something to do on Friday nights and stay involved in the game of football.
Is it higher or lower than in years past?
It's higher. Okay. It's higher. We've done a big push on recruiting. We've gone out and, you know, hey, bring a friend. And our membership has taken heed to that because it's we have to survive in the next 3 to 4 years by bringing in 40 or 50 at a time to make up for more than what's leaving.